And what could Britney Spears possibly do to top this? Would you believe she sat down to talk to Tucker Carlson? From the CNN Broadcast Center in New York, this is Live from the Headlines.
Well, Britney Spears isn't the usual topic of political discussions. I think I say state the obvious there. But after her kiss with Madonna at the MTV Awards show, she's once again found herself in the crossfire of the culture wars. Spears was in Washington for tomorrow's NFL kickoff, so who better to talk with her than crossfire co-host Tucker Carlson? Take a look.
I was reading the Star. I know you haven't seen this, but in here, there's a picture of you coming out of a restaurant grabbing your stomach, and it made me think, are you shadowed all the time?
Wait, what?
Just picture of you, a stuffed Britney Spears holds her stomach like anyone would after eating too much.
I guess my food must have been really good for me to do that.
Do you see photographers following you all the time?
Yeah. Yeah, well, it's not all the time. I mean, kind of in L.A., there's usually a lot of photographers and stuff. But when I go to London, it's not as bad. It's cool when I go overseas. I can kind of escape a little bit.
You went there after the kiss. Mm-hmm. Tell me, give me the chronology of the kiss. How did you decide to kiss Madonna?
Well, actually, when rehearsals, it wasn't something that was like, you know, this is what we're going to do, you know. It was just kind of like, we played around a little bit. And she said before the performance, let's just feel it out and see what happens. So I didn't know it was going to be that long and everything, but it was cool.
Had you ever kissed a woman before?
No, I've never kissed a woman before.
Would you again?
Would I again? No, I would not do it. Oh, maybe with Madonna, but I'm
But that's it? You're going to stay true to Madonna as far as
kissing? Yeah, Madonna, yeah.
What does your mom think?
What does my mom think?
Yeah.
She thinks it was cool. She liked the performance. She knows it's about performing and it's not like, you know... So.
How do you think your fans who followed you from your days in the as a Mouseketeer up till now, are they happy with the change in your image?
I mean, honestly, it's about me just performing and expressing myself. And I think when someone sees you up on stage having fun and you're fulfilling your dream, they're inspired by that, and that's what matters.
So you don't notice any sort of shift in the way you present yourself? 3 years ago was sort of the, you know, example of clean living, and do you think that's changed?
I think I'm still clean living, you know. When I don't go home and have orgies or anything like that, I'm still the same person that I've always been, so.
You're going to be on the National Mall soon, performing for Pepsi and the NFL, and also to support our troops. A lot of entertainers have come out against the war in Iraq. Have you?
Honestly, I think we should just trust our president in every decision that he makes, and we should just support that, you know, and be faithful in what happens.
Do you trust this president?
Yes, I do.
Excellent. Do you think he's going to win again?
I don't know. I don't know that.
You work with Pepsi for a long time.
Easy boy.
Candidly. Just between you and me, how much Pepsi do you think you drink on an average day?
I really do like Pepsi.
Really? What's your favorite kind?
I really do. My favorite kind of Pepsi? Pepsi's Pepsi.
Well, you don't drink Diet Pepsi or
No,
Pepsi
regular Pepsi.
So what are your favorite shows on television?
My favorite shows on television? Sex and the City, definitely. Sex and the City, Friends, of course. And I like these reality shows on MTV now. I think it's very humorous to watch the new Jessica Simpson and Nick Lachey show and the Wade Robson Project. I love that.
Do you watch a lot of CNN?
Oh, CNN all the time. All
Good.
The time.
I knew I liked you, Britney.
You know?
Are you going to make another movie?
I would love to. I would love to
Do
make
have
another
movie. Do you have
any plans
in the near future?
Right now I'm kind of just... really focusing on my music, but seriously, I would love to do I would love to do a musical. I'd love to do it all.
And you said you're thinking about moving to London. Mm-hmm. Why?
It's the one place that I feel completely anonymous, and I just like the way they treasure everything. Everything's very simply done, and you know, the milkman still comes to the door, you know, and I like the simplicity of that. I think that's very cool, and I don't know.
Do you feel like your life is too complicated?
Too complicated?
Yeah.
Sometimes it's a little, you know, but I think there's just an energy there. It's very cool.
and the cool and complicated Tucker Carlson joins us right now. Tucker, what I really want to ask you is, did she at least offer you a stick of her own gum? But what I'm going to end up asking you is, what, you know, you sat down with her. What is she really like? What she seem like at just sitting one on one?
She seemed very young. She seemed younger than a person who would bare her midriff. I mean, the impression I came away with was that it would be wrong to have adult thoughts about Britney Spears. I mean, she may be 21, but she seems, again, young, in a nice way. But I mean, this is someone, you know, who's been in entertainment most of her life, and I think she leads a very different life than we do, say, in cable. You know, kind of sequestered.
Yeah, I also doubt she really watches CNN, but that's for another time. Tucker Carlson, thanks very much. It was fun.
Thanks, right. James.